Good evening, Doc Judy and Doc G. For my research translation workshop, I've chosen the study on risk assessment of common health problems in core shelters of the Gagarao City. One of the rehabilitation projects of the government implemented by the Department of Social Welfare and Development is the immediate provision of shelter to disaster-affected indigent families whose houses were totally damaged and blown down. The agency also provides relocation sites, which eventually can become permanent residents to families whose lots were reclaimed and their houses were demolished as highways, bridges, or any public-owned infrastructure that needs to be erected. This is also a restoration and rehabilitation strategy that involves beneficiaries themselves to provide labor for the construction of their houses. Region 2 is the second top implementer of the Core Shelter Assistance Program in the country with a total of 3,083 core shelter units. The province of Cagayan has 1,019 units situated in the different towns. In Tuguegarao City, there are three identified core shelters located in low-lying rural barangays, namely Anafunan East, which has 100 housing units, Katagaman Pardo having 57 units, and Namambalan having 51 units respectively. These core shelters are expected to provide decent, safe, and disaster-resilient housing units. However, this is not the reality in the three core shelters in Tuguegarao City. In our 2019 PCHRD-funded and published study, we found out that the residents are uncomfortable, displeased, and unsafe being in the core shelters. The residents experience flooding even with slight rains, and worse, they are catch basins during floods. Houses are totally submerged during typhoons. Aside from this, drainage system and accessibility are also issues. Further, core shelter houses are like Legos. Residents constructed their own houses after a training, and some houses are canned like sardines as they have duplex houses. In fact, the wide range of health conditions common in all of the core shelters, including infectious diseases, injuries, and social problems, are all linked to the housing issues. Through focus group discussions, supplemented by key informant interview, survey, and documents review of the assessment study done in these shelters, infectious diseases, injuries, and social problems are the common in all of the three core shelters. Infectious diseases result primarily from vector-borne, followed by waterborne, then respiratory and skin infections. Common vector-borne conditions are dengue and chikungunya, and there are a few cases of leptospirosis and malaria. Loose bowel movement and amebiasis are usual waterborne diseases, while cough, colds, flu, tuberculosis, pneumonia, and asthma are common respiratory diseases. Now worsened with the COVID-19 virus, by which Tuguegarao City is the top municipality in Region 2 with the highest number of cases as of August 2021. Fungal infections and eczema are common skin diseases experienced. However, injuries result mostly from dog bites, minor falls and burns, and a few cases of assault, which usually happens under the influence of liquor. Vices such as cigarette smoking and drinking alcohol are the chief social problem, followed closely by poverty and few cases of teenage pregnancy. This is the status of the core shelters as to flooding, drainage, and stagnant water. So you can see that the Anafunan East core shelter experiences the worst flooding, and common in the three core shelters is the drainage problem and the presence of stagnant water. The three core shelters also have problem with waste disposal, although there is a system for the garbage collection and segregation. Also, they have problems with the presence of stray animals, and we have here dogs and rodents. The general objective of this study is to assess the common health and social problems of the residents in the core shelters of the Geguero City. Specifically, this study attempted to answer the following questions. What is the profile of the core shelters in terms of the general characteristics and its environmental condition? Second, what is the profile of the core shelter housing units in terms of household size, housing structure, water and sanitation infrastructure, and access to infrastructure? And lastly, what are the most common health problems of the residents in the different core shelters? Healthy housing is not just concerned with the sanitary and hygienic design of the shelter, but with the whole health spectrum. A decent accommodation, as we all know now, since we are all working from home, is a direct or indirect contributing factor to the promotion of the social well-being of an individual. And in this study, the majority of health-related and social problems are preventable, and the assessed common health and social issues are necessary to determine the health status and see the factors affecting the family's health in the core shelters. Hence, we came up with this core shelter or core project health, where H stands for healthy houses, E for evaluation, L for learning, and P for planning. For healthy houses as a whole, through rapid assessment of the houses in the core shelters to determine how can the units be improved to prevent infectious diseases and injuries. And specifically, to provide each household with first aid kits as well as survival kits. First aid kits for in terms of injuries that they experience, survival kits in terms of in times of typhoons and other disasters, and also a healthy house, a provision of starter packs of livelihood packages such as urban gardening to unemployed residents. This is as a solution to their unemployment and poverty issues, and also to do something productive at their residence. For the evaluation of the core project health, this is in terms of the environment. This mainly involves fixing their drainage system, establishing a segregation facility within the core shelter for proper waste disposal, and facilitating regular garbage collection. Specifically, number one, to provide the necessary materials to repair or improve the core shelter housing units, the making, rehabilitation, and improvement of the drainage and sanitation facility in the core shelters, mainly in Anafunan and Katagaman, to avert the episodes of flooding in these areas, which eventually prevents the prevalence of vector-borne and water-borne diseases, which usually escalates during rainy or typhoon seasons. And third, to provide garbage cans as well as putting up a garbage segregation facility. Third, for core project health is letter L, for residents to learn the crucial role of their houses in preventing their health problems through health promotion. Also, to conduct capacitation seminars or trainings on disaster risk reduction and management, waste management, relevant health and social issues such as VAUC, tropical and neglected diseases, and intensive information education campaign in the prevention of the common diseases in the core shelters such as vector-borne, water-borne, respiratory, and skin infections, as well as on personal and environmental sanitation practices. Specifically, to conduct the intensive information education campaign, and number two, include health education and awareness programs from the making of customized IEC materials, doing lectures or classes, as well as training demonstrations in the core shelters. Lastly, planning as to how the current pressing concerns are given solutions. This is in terms of number one, capacity building of the core shelter community leaders. This is for barangay council and the core shelter officers, especially in emergency response to health risk ancestors, environmental sanitation campaigns, and the implementation of law and order in the community in close coordination with LGU and cooperating agencies. And the establishment of a functional office or a watch center for the officials of the core shelters to meet regularly for meetings and other concerns, making the organization visible, accessible, and functional will address the urgent needs of the residents in the core shelters. Should the conditions in the core shelter not be improved, what kind of future lies for the residents? Should they be pockets of poverty? Is it not that they are vulnerable groups who must be prioritized? That is why we came up with Core Project Help, which will positively impact approximately 1,500 people, and it encompasses physical and mental health, education, capacity building, food and water security, and economic growth, diversity, equity, and inclusion, and sustainable cities and communities. That is all. Thank you. I'm not sure if this is research translation, but this is the plans, and this is what I think should be done after this study with the risk assessment of common health problems in core shelters of the Geger City. Thank you so much, Doc G and Doc Judy, and in advance for the comments and suggestions for this research translation. Thank you.